All right, Brian. Well, nobody's going to get a good amount of sleep, and nobody's going to be calm until we answer the most pressing question on the minds of everybody today around the wrestling world, the hot issue that everybody's talking about it. Who's Danny Garcia going to sign with?
Well, Daniel Garcia, to be clear. Danny Garcia is the gigantic wife or ex-wife of The Rock, not the AEW wrestler.
Well, if you're friends with him, do you have to call him Daniel? Can you maybe Dan?
Maybe. I don't
know. Hey, maybe Big D. You doesn't got to call him Daniel.
This is a story because we've been talking about the idea that WWE, I guess they went and made a play for Swerve, and Swerve signed a renewal with AEW that was for an amount that WWE was shocked by. The thought was that the same thing is going to happen with Daniel Garcia. And now there's a headline, and a bunch of the listeners have been sending this over this morning from the Wrestling Observer newsletter website by Ian Carey. AEW less confident Daniel Garcia will resign.
Ooh.
If I go to the article here, AEW is not as confident as they once were that Daniel Garcia will resign with the company. Always repeat the headline as the first sentence, I guess. Last month, it was reported that while Garcia and AEW had not come to terms on a new deal, the promotion believed he was most likely staying. However, our own Dave Meltzer noted on last night's Wrestling Observer Radio.
I'm glad they claim him.
Noted on last night's Wrestling Observer Radio that AEW is no longer as certain as they once were. Why don't we stop there for a second? Again, Daniel Garcia's contract's coming out. What was the last? Was the last time we saw him when he wrestled MJF at the pay-per-view?
Well, that's right. Where is Danny?
He hasn't been on TV.
He laid out MJF bad enough that MJF is selling injuries and is off television. And now Danny Garcia hurt MJF so bad Danny Garcia is selling the injuries and he's off television. So I don't understand. One would think that if they wanted to capitalize on what they did at the pay-per-view, they would have the guy that triumphantly slayed the dragon, MJF, and got even for the treacherous and horrible things that have been done to him and blah, 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 to come and crow about it. But instead, he's hidden too. So that means they're ashamed. They probably have buyer's remorse now for what they did on the pay-per-view, because if the knucklehead doesn't come back, then the last time we saw him in the company was he's a fucking middle card bleh who laid out the top heel in the company. Harley has an allergy, by the way, for those that might be listening in. So how does that make sense, Brian? That they would have both of them off television, and why, if you didn't know that this guy was coming back, would you have him lay out the top guy in the company?
Well, let's see if this explains that. Here's a quote from Dave Meltzer. As far as what's going to happen with him, I would say this. I would say that the almost surety, or the strong confidence that he was signing, I wouldn't say it's as strong, but I wouldn't say that he's leaving either. But it may not be as strong as it was a month ago. He may leave.
What? What?
I don't know what I just read.
Was that? That's a quote, right?
As far as what's going to happen with him, I would say this. All right, so this is what he's saying. I would say that the almost surety, or the strong confidence that he was signing, I wouldn't say it's as strong, but I wouldn't say that he's leaving either. But it's not as strong as it was a month ago. He may leave. Are these lyrics on like another level? He's singing from both sides of the relationship.
I do believe it's not as strong as it was last month. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
He may stay. He may leave. Meltzer.
Thank you. I must be going. Might be the new theme song they play on Saturday nights.
Meltzer continued to say that Garcia not being on AEW programming of late is due to his not having re-signed. Meltzer says Tony Khan is often hesitant to put talent on AEW programming if he feels they are likely going to leave the company when their contracts are up.
What? Hence
Miro in Bulgaria for 5 years.
they will send him to the Russian front.
Here's a quote from Dave. If they believe somebody's not going to sign, and that's why a lot of guys that you see or don't see, there's a reason that you don't see, because the belief is when their contract is up, they are going to go. And if that's the case, Tony's just not going to put them on TV. He could go in there and job them, but some of them complain. But some of them complain.
Oh my God.
He just didn't want to put them on TV in a lot of cases. I think we've seen that. And with that, we want to say hello to Ricky Starks out there in Texas. We hope you're doing well. We hope to see you soon.
Is he the one of the sick and shut-ins that listens to our program? But back up. Back the fuck up a second. How long before the end of your contract? I could understand. Yeah, the fuck, he's checked out. He's 6 weeks, his contract is up, whatever the fuck. We don't need him anyway. He put so-and-so up, whatever. But a year and a fucking half? When we don't see some of these, there are plenty of people that we don't see for a year, year and a half, and then they come back. And they're back for a while. And then they go away. So you can't really tell, but how long before these alleged people's contracts are up, does he just say, oh, just go home and I'll mail you a check every week? Because a lot of these people are gone for a long fucking time. So then is that...
That's the move.
That's the thing. Now
that's
is
the
that,
move.
Yeah, if you sign for 3 years, is it going to be that you only have to work the first two and then just let them know, fuck it, I ain't happy, and you get the extra year as a bonus?
Listen, I'm a wrestler. My family want to spend time with me. Day one, I announce I'm signing with WWE in 3 years. And then I go home. And then when he brings me in, I tell him that I complain about the booking, and I complain about who he wants me to job to, and then he sends me home and pays me more. I like this is the wrestler's dream. Garcia, who turned 26 last week, debuted in AEW on an episode of Dark in September 2020. AEW announced he signed a full-time deal in October 2021. Garcia is a former Ring of Honor Pure Champion and the current Pro Wrestling Guerrilla World Champion.
But only in the orangutan division. I know there's being sure and there's taking people's words, and I've been the victim of trying to, believe the best of people in the past. But he didn't even deserve to be in a pay-per-view match with MJF. He's just a piece of goddamn cake with no icing. It's fine. It's just there. It needs something. Maybe later down the road, whatever the fuck. But when it's MJF and it's your top heel and the guy hasn't signed and you say, oh, just fucking hospitalize MJF. It'll be all right.
And beyond that, and take Daniel Garcia out of the picture. It could be any wrestler. If your philosophy is, I don't know if I'm going to re-sign him, so I'm going to keep him off TV. Why did you spend months building him up? They just built him up for the MJF thing. He lost the match, got the pile drivers at the end, and then he disappeared. What sense did that make? Was that a better feud than MJF versus Hechicero?
Oh, I forgot about Chichichichia. So if Garcia doesn't... Well, here, though, this is goddamn...
This is going to make him a babyface in AEW when he resigns now.
But here's what he's done. Here's what he's done. Because Tony seems to me to have an orderly mind about these things, about his ideas. He wants his ideas to come to fruition. So now he knows if this knucklehead doesn't sign again, then MJF will never get his revenge. So he's automatically got to pay more to make sure that he re-signs, because elsewise, Tony's big angle will be all for naught. That's what it is. Because I got to be honest with you, what is the WWE wanting there that they haven't got? What attribute of Garcia's are they wanting to purchase there that they don't have people that have multiple examples of that particular talent or skill or whatever the case?
I don't know. I don't know what their motivation is or isn't. But if you're Garcia, and this is true...
Or are they just trying to drive Tony's fucking payroll up again?
If you're Garcia, and this is true, and you have Tony Khan offering you above market value versus WWE offering you fair or maybe even below fair market value to come in, but you'll be in NXT and you'll be part of it. The system. The vortex. You know, you never know what happens. And, you know, give someone like that a couple of years in NXT. Who knows? Who knows how they develop with real... You know, I'm not even going to get into his initial training. He's been in AEW for a few years. We hear from enough people and we know enough about what's going on there. That's not a great place to grow and learn. And who knows what NXT would do for him. Also, Brandon Thurston trained him. Brandon Thurston of WrestleNomics. If this kid has a couple bitters, he's also got people he could talk to about what the hell should I do.
Well, yeah, he should be a human calculator. So he's got that going for him.
What would you do if you were him?
I'd jump off a bridge.
No, seriously, all that money from Tony for 3 or 5 years versus 3-year deal from WWE. They send you to NXT. We'll see how it goes. You're not going to make as much. You have to move to Florida.
From what I've seen of Mr. Garcia, if I was Mr. Garcia, I'd take Tony's money. If now, if Garcia in 5 years is a big star, and I'm not talking about if Tony's still around, I'm talking about as a big star in his business, probably in the WWE to be a big star in his business, then I will, you can play me the tape of those words and I'll cut up the tape and eat it on the air.
Yeah, I don't know if that would benefit anyone. So we're not going to do that.
Well, that's something we can build to. We can advertise. Garcia's got 5 years from right now to become a superstar, or elsewise I'm going to have to eat tape on the air.
This is how I can tell you're becoming...
This is programming.
This is
here.
The sign that you're aging right here. It used to be just a few years ago. I will strip naked and march down Main Street playing songs and singing and dancing.
Well, it's something now that I have the energy to really do that I would do. But see, it's long-term storytelling. Because people be counting down the time. Will he have to eat his words?
If you know you have someone you as a booker like and want to do things with, and their contract's coming up in a year or 6 months or 3 months or 6 weeks, how do you treat it?
Well, if it's coming up in a fucking year, you still try to get as much out of them as you can get. And, you know, if they become a superstar, you'd like to keep them. You pay them more if they get over real good. But there's no reason to start fucking ushering a guy out the door who's going to be with you for a year. 6 months to 90 days, you know, well, let's start thinking about what's going on. Do I... have a spot for him, or is somebody else I'd like to bring in and be fresher or whatever? And then talk to him. Does he want to hang around, or has he got interest in going somewhere else? But not a year, and certainly not next month. Your contract's up. What the fuck? Would you like to pile drive some people and incapacitate them and then decide later? There's some middle ground in between that.
Well, that's AEW contract news.
Speaking of...
And Dave Meltzer turning into Captain Beefheart.
What is it? God damn it. It's just... I used to think, you know, and there was... I'll just make this brief comment. There was some element of... I know he's just rushing to type some things, right? You could overlook that. But now it's like, how does he think that way and come out the other end of it?